Hey fans, fighters, subscribers and YouTubers, and welcome to the most spectacular fighting show on YouTube, Fighters That Will Always Be Remembered. This show includes documentary stories of famous boxers, UFC fighters and K1 fighters that left an undeletable trail in their sport and should always remain known and famous for their achievements. Please follow episodes, send your propositions to my Facebook, and make sure that your fighter gets the next story.
Hello and welcome. Welcome to one more episode of Fighters That Will Always Be Remembered. Tonight we're talking about Conor McGregor, a former UFC champion. He's still a champion of featherweight and the guy who probably made the craziest decision ever in the world of UFC. He, believe it or not, fought Nate Diaz. Two categories higher ranking. Got to be really insane for that. He could suffer a heavy KO. But this is just Conor McGregor. I mean, that's just him. You see his broken nose. See his broken nose. I mean, insane guy. What can you say? Two categories go up. I just don't know how Diaz did not harm him so badly. And McGregor's nose is something that will be remembered for a long time, definitely. You got to be really, really crazy to do the things Conor McGregor did. Now, he was born 14th July 1988, an Irish mixed martial artist, primarily competing in featherweight division of UFC. He was planning to go lightweight, welterweight, fought welterweight versus Nate Diaz. And he is number 8 pound for pound fighter in the world of Sherdog. He is born in Dublin, Ireland. He has nicknames The Notorious and Mystic Mac. Height 5'9". Weight, well, it was 77 kilograms now. But his primary weight is around 70, 72. He was most of his life featherweight. Reach 188 centimeters. Team SBG Ireland. Trainers: John Cavanaugh, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Owen Roddy, striking. Johnny Dagan, Taekwondo. Ido Portal, movement. Sergey Pikulski, wrestling. He is a brown belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. He has a very attractive techniques. He has strong punches. He has really good distance. He is also a strong guy. And he also had a good spinning techniques, which are from Taekwondo, since I know that, since I was a Taekwondoka. And let's talk now about his early life. He was playing football for Leeds Celtic Football Club and supported Manchester United. He moved with his family to Lucan in West Dublin, attending Gaucho Isticois Core Life. Following that, he commenced a plumbing apprenticeship while in Lucan. He began sparring with future UFC fighter Tom Egan, who taught McGregor how to grapple and ignited his passion for mixed martial arts. McGregor's main goal was to reach the UFC. He was saying that he never planned to be a champion of the world, but it just happened. In amateur career, Conor McGregor had one match. He fought against Ciarán Campbell for the Irish Ring of Truth promotion. In Dublin, he was victorious via TKO in the first round. Following the fight, he turned professional, was signed by Irish Cage of Truth promotion. In 2008, began training at the Straight Blast Gym in Dublin under John Cavanaugh. However, he is solid in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, but he has only one submission victory. What can you see later when I start to talk about him? In total, 22 fights, 19 wins, 17 by knockout, 1 by submission, 1 by decision, 3 losses, all 3 by submission. I gotta say, when you watch Conor McGregor's fight, chances that you will watch the whole fight are decreased to zero. I mean, only one fight was finished to the end. Since Conor goes everything or nothing, he is just that type of fighter. He had a streak of 14 wins in the UFC till Nate Diaz crushed this record. Let's just talk now about his fights. In first fight on March 8, 2008, TKO punches Cage of Truth. He fought in Dublin, Ireland versus Gary Morris. In second round, only 8 seconds was needed. McGregor was finishing most of his fights via TKO punches. A second fight versus Mo Taylor was also won on brutality of TKO punches. Only one round was needed. And first loss of Conor McGregor versus Artemi Sinko, because McGregor went on top of him, but Sinko did an amazing reversal, caught his knee and went for amazing knee bar, pulling his leg, and this was the end of McGregor's hopes. In later fight versus Stephen Bailey, also first round, 1 minute 22 seconds, also TKO punches. McGregor was purely dominating this round. Fifth fight versus Conor Dillon, TKO corner stoppage. They fought in Derry, not an island, and McGregor placed Dillon in the corner. He was punching and kneeing, and when he went down, they just threw the towel in. Second defeat of Conor McGregor happened versus Joseph Duffy via submission arm triangle choke. It was Cage Warriors 39, the uprising, November 27, 2010. Fought in Cook Island. This is the fastest defeat of Conor McGregor, arm triangle choke. I just, whenever I remember that fight, you know, I just remember that Conor McGregor made a fatal mistake when he went down, and Duffy was an amazing submission guy. I mean, he should never let him take him down, and whenever he caught him like this over here, it was just a matter of time when the fight will be over. The next fight versus Hugh Brady, also in Derry, not an island. McGregor was also in a pure domination. He was rolling him over, he was striking him, he was even attractive in this fight, and only 2 minutes 31 seconds. I really can say that these were moments when Conor McGregor started to dominate from that fight, also versus Mike Wood, only 16 seconds in Cage Contender 8, March 12, 2011. I can say that these were pure domination. I mean, 16 seconds later in Letterkenny Island versus Paddy Doherty. This is maybe, at least what I know, this is the fastest knockout I have ever seen in the world of mixed martial arts. I just don't know statistics, maybe there were, I know one knockout was after 1 or 2 seconds, but after 4 seconds he crushed Paddy Doherty via strong left straight that went really strong to his chin, and McGregor started to strike him, but referee stopped the fight immediately. Later fought versus Artur Sovinsky. It was also a good fight. I mean, Sovinsky was a guy who made a lot of mistakes, but trying to, you know, with his front hand. McGregor is a natural southpaw, and this is the reason why many people are making that type of mistake. You attack him with left, it is very easy for him, since he is a longer guy, to slip and to strike you with the right straight. Sovinsky really showed that he had no chance in this fight, despite he survived the first round and fascinated most of the crowd that were watching this match. Versus Aaron Johnson, also TKO punches, September 8, 2011. It was a lightweight bout. This was second time McGregor fought in a lightweight after his loss to Joseph Duffy. And Aaron Johnson was not, was not a proper opponent for him. McGregor was also dominating. McGregor threw also a few attractive strikes. And I can only say that McGregor did not place so much power on this fight. He was in domination from the beginning to the start. Later win versus Steve O'Keefe, KO elbows. Well, these elbows are maybe the best KO, most attractive KO for me at least, from Conor McGregor. When he took him down, He was just throwing various elbows in Kentish Town, England. Only one round lasted, but what I think is that that McGregor threw one 12-6 elbow, or it was in the back of the head, which I cannot say 100%. But when I was watching this match, I have some thinking that Steve O'Keefe was a little bit damaged here, because it would be at least 1 point abduction, according to my opinion. Versus Dave Hill, this was the only Conor McGregor's submission victory, since Conor is a type of a guy who doesn't submit people many much. I mean, he won CVCF featherweight championship via rare naked choke. He was punching Dave Hill, but this guy didn't wanted to surrender, didn't wanted to stop the fight, and he had to choke him. This was maybe the only choice, what can I say. And later fought for lightweight championship versus Ivan Buchinger, KO punch, December 31st, 2012 in Dublin, Ireland. Well, Buchinger made also a critical mistake. He ran on McGregor. You should never run on type of a guy like Conor McGregor is, because his hands are long, his kicks are brutal. He even dominated, which I will talk later, Dennis Siver on the kicks, and Dennis Siver is a taekwondoka, third dan in taekwondo. You should never ever run on Conor McGregor. This is a critical error that Buchinger made, and this KO punch was only a matter of seconds, matter of split seconds. Victory versus Marcus Brimage. TKO punch is only 1 round, 1 minute 7 seconds in Stockholm, Sweden. He returned to fatter weight. It was a knockout of the night. And in that fight, I mean, it was pure domination from the beginning. This is the most domination of Conor McGregor's fights, were like this fight versus Marcus Brimage. Just from the beginning, start strong, purely dominate, and just strike strong. He's a natural southpaw. This is something that minds most of the fighters. Only decision victory versus Max Holloway, Boston, Massachusetts, United States of America. Well, this was his second UFC fight, and Holloway was an endurable guy. Really, really showed good endurance. He surprised me with that. I was fascinated. Conor McGregor was, how to say, completely gassed in the end, but he was able to win. Versus Diego Brandão, also TKO punches, also pure domination from the beginning, performance of the night. And Dustin Poirier, UFC 178, 1 minute 48 seconds. McGregor was in a pure phase of domination. He even threw a few head kicks. Poirier was trying to take him down, was trying to get close. He could really do nothing. McGregor was superior in that fight. Maybe if he survived 2 or 3 rounds, maybe, but it was also performance of the night. One more performance of the night versus Dennis Siver via TKO punches. And the fight was non-celebrated for me, at least. Dennis Siver is the third dan of Taekwondo, and McGregor was killing him on his kicks, which is not typical, since Siver is a taekwondoka, taekwondo master with the best spinning back kick in the world of UFC, at least what I know. And McGregor was purely crushing him. I mean, he never ever gave him one more hope that he will be able to win this fight. He was just throwing strong punches. Even Siver was standing in the guard like this, and McGregor was striking. McGregor was not stopping. I even wonder how Conor McGregor could survive to strike so many times without being fatigued. They were fighting for 1.5 rounds. It is not an easy task to be done. Later win over Chad Mendes. This was a good fight in Las Vegas, Nevada. This fight was good, I cannot say. I was impressed with how Mendes was sleeping. Whenever McGregor threw his left punch, Mendes went to the side and threw his right punch. This is something probably Mendes was training, but he was not prepared for McGregor, definitely. Definitely his physics was lower than McGregor's, and McGregor, as well as you can say, McGregor ate him in that fight. I mean, he crushed him completely. He demolished him. He won the interim UFC featherweight championship also with performance of the night. Jose Aldo, maybe the most controversial match in UFC Undisputed 3. Jose Aldo has 94 grade, which is, after John Bones Jones, the best fighter. McGregor showed him who the boss is after only 13 seconds when Aldo attacked just one straight. Good night, Jose. And also UFC featherweight performance of the night. I'd say also knockout of the night. I can also say that Conor McGregor destroyed the bookers in this fight, because many people, according to many people I knew, bet on Jose Aldo, who had amazing results till then. He was champion for a long period of time. He held that title really, really long time. He was pronounced nearly undefeatable, and Conor McGregor crushed that myth, later fought versus Nate Diaz. Maybe the most controversial match in the world of UFC ever. In the beginning, Nate Diaz was striking, but he was striking one and McGregor continued to strike. McGregor was purely dominative in the first round. The critical error that Conor McGregor made is that he should never ever go with Nate Diaz in ground, and that strike he received. Diaz has amazing cardio. This was welterweight debut fight of the night, but Diaz's cardio was something that gave him advantage in the second round when he placed him strong. Strike him here. McGregor was mounted and he tried to flip, but when you give back to guys like Nate Diaz, it cannot be finished well. For me, Nate Diaz's style is not the best thing you can see in the world of UFC. But it is very, very effective, and this is the reason why he lost this match. And I just need to say that McGregor was using in his career a lot of psychological warfare against his opponents. He have led some commentators, including Dana White, to compare him to Muhammad Ali, whom McGregor cites as one of his early inspirations. He won UFC featherweight one time. UFC interim featherweight one time, Cage Warriors one time, knockout of the night one time, performance of the night five times, fight of the night one time, most performance of the night awards five, most consecutive performance of the night awards five, most knockouts in the fetter division six, fastest the fight finished 13 seconds, highest attendance in the United States, highest gate in the United States, highest turning per second at UFC 194, cover athlete one time for EA Sports UFC 2, first multi-division champion at featherweight and lightweight, Lionel featherweight championship, 2014 fighter of the year, 2015 international fighter of the year, 2015 fighter of the year. He has so many wonderful achievements. I mean, Conor McGregor is a guy why I love this sport so much. He came on my list of my favorite fighters since he is a natural southpaw. His left hand and left arm are just killing those people. And I hope that he will defend his title just like he was doing in the beginning of his career. I think fight versus Diaz was a bit an error, because, you know, Diaz is a lot stronger guy, a lot taller guy. And also, I didn't say, McGregor is mostly of a showman. He's a good guy. You saw him in that video clip and he went to that guy who had McGregor's photo and Irish flag. He went there. He's a good guy, but he likes the psychological warfare. He's a showman. He's just that type of fighter. This is what I can say. This is what I can say for Conor McGregor. He makes this sport interesting, and I hope I will watch his fight soon and see McGregor again as the champion of featherweight or lightweight.
Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and subscribe us on YouTube. Send us your propositions to make sure to see your favorite fighter in this show. Thanks, and see you all in the next episode.